Konnichiwa. Hello, everyone. This is the duck in Japan. And we are into the deep heat of our summer. It's already over 85 degrees and it's not quite 8 a.m. yet. Today I'm standing in front of a rice paddy. The area where we are has lots of small plots of agricultural land, whether it be rice or some of the bigger cash crops in our area. At least when I got here over 30 years ago, were things like apples and grapes and carnations. But in my informal estimate of walking around this town, which I do a lot of, I would say in the 30 years that I've been here, over half of the farming land has gone fallow in that it's no longer being farmed. And there are a couple factors that have to do with that. One is that traditionally, our area of the main island of Japan, Honshu, doesn't receive very much precipitation. Usually our rainy seasons are quite dry. So most of the rain that we get is actually from typhoons. That doesn't make this place very ideal for growing rice like the big plains of Tokyo and Osaka were traditionally. And that's really why the centers of Japanese civilization became places like that. Our area is very mountainous. It doesn't receive very much rain, so it's harder to grow rice. When I first came here 30 years ago in search for the answer of why there are so many small factories. In fact, for this little town of 16,000 people, there were over 400 factories. So one in every 40 people, you had to call him President so-and-so. One of the first factories in this town made metal files. And the reason that they came here from Tokyo before the war was that metal files don't rust here because there's no rain. And so this is a much better place. Their factory used to be in Shibaura, which is right up against the bay of Tokyo. So they had lots of problems. And their big hit product was, after the war, lighters, the strikers for lighters, which are made out of files. So after the war, those became very popular with American GIs. Anyway, our little town, when I got here 30 years ago, was booming. A lot of the factories had three shifts, and you know, you would see small factories next to rice paddies and other agriculture going on side by side. And now it's this wonderful little sleepy town where there's still some factories, there's still some farming going on, but for the large part, this place is moving on to a new kind of coexistence of agriculture and industry and other things like tourism. Of course, with the pandemic, tourism is kind of like on the wayside right now. Anyway, thank you for watching my videos and for your helpful comments and suggestions about what to do next. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Mata ne.
I am wrong.